Hello everyone, welcome back to Engineer's Creation. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to quickly customize your popcorn bags. This is a very quick and easy tutorial, and you're going to see how easy this is. You can find your popcorn bags anywhere, even on Amazon, Dollar Tree, and stuff like that. And I'm going to show you how easy it is. So let's get started. For your supplies, you're going to need a pair of scissors, measuring tape, your popcorn bags. You can get your popcorn bags wherever you choose to. I found these at the Dollar Tree, but also Amazon carries them. They're 8 for $1. And your choice of sticker paper. I got this one from Amazon. The brand is Online Labels, and it is compatible with my printer. I have an inkjet printer. If you have a laser printer, make sure you get laser sticker paper. Again, this is 8.5 by 11 regular matte sticker paper. You can get glossy, you can get anything that you would like, and you could also get any other different brand of sticker paper. So the first thing you need to do is you're going to measure where you want to put your label. I just want to put a oval label around where it says popcorn, and that's why you're going to need your measuring tape. Now, this is the bags that I have. Whatever bags you may have, they're going to be different probably than mine's. So just measure the width and the height, and then you enter those measurements into the software that you're going to be using. Of course, y'all know I use Silhouette Studio, so I'm going to show you how I'm going to design it. Okay, the first thing you need to do is open up your software. I'll be using Silhouette Studio. I have Silhouette Studio Business Edition. You can use Basic Edition. Basic Edition is free. I have a whole separate tutorial on how to download Basic Edition for free. You need to go straight to the Silhouette America's website. If you do want to upgrade to Business Edition, check down below for my affiliate link. I get it from Swing Design. And you do not need to have a cutting machine to use this software. First thing you need to do is set up your paper size. So the icon on your right, it looks like a paper. You're going to go there, and where it says media size, put it for 8.5 by 11 because that is the paper size that I'm going to be printing on. After that, you are going to make sure you first measured your bag where you want to put your label, and then we're going to make that shape. So right here on my left, I'm going to click on shapes, click on the oval shape, and then I'm going to make any size oval here on my screen. I'm going to go up here where it says, make sure my oval selected, go up here where it says width, and I'm going to type 4.6 and enter. And on my height, I'm going to type 3 and enter. After that, make sure it's selected. On my right, where it has the outline, that's called the outline or the line style panel, where it says thickness, I'm going to go up on the thickness on however you feel like it's good enough, like that. And I'm going to leave it on black. I'm going to go to the color and change it to black. Then I'm going to, while selected, I'm going to go to my offset panel. That is the double star. I'm going to click on internal offset. And then I'm going to play with the distance for that as well. And then I'm going to go back to my line panel. And I'm going to go down on the thickness for that one. Click here on my screen, somewhere on my screen. Drag my mouse to group them both together. Right click and group. So now it moves together. Then I'm going to click on the A on my left, A on my right. Click on the font that I want to use. I'm going to be using Cooper Black. You can download free fonts from thefont.com. I'll have a whole separate tutorial on that. I'm going to click somewhere on my screen, and I'm going to start typing. Once I'm done typing, I'm going to click somewhere else on my screen to get off the edit mode. Click back on the font. While I'm still here on the A on where's the textile, I'm going to click on center. Go to the fill panel that looks like a paint palette. Color it the color that you want. And then make sure that you have the correct font that you want before you do anything else. So this is the font that I want, because once you do changes, you cannot go back and change the font. So I'm going to right click it and ungroup it. I'm going to click on the S, and where the green little circle is on top, I'm just going to tilt it to the side. And I'm going to do this with all the letters. Now, you don't have to do this. This is just what I want to do.
Now I'm going to click somewhere here on my screen, drag my mouse over all the letters, right click and group it together. Then I'm going to put it right here in the center of my oval shape. And the way you size your items is with the little white rectangles, you size your stuff. I'm going to click here on my screen, drag my mouse over everything, and I'm going to go to my transform panel on my right. I'm going to have the option where it says center. You have two options, which the first one is center to page. Second one is to center both images together, and I'm going to click on that one. Now everything is centered. I'm going to group it together. I like grouping so nothing moves while I keep adding stuff. Now if you go to Google or wherever you look for your images, I looked up movie PNG. Then when you click on one, how you know it's a PNG image is if it's gray and white squares behind it, that means it is a transparent background image. You're going to save the images that you want. You're going to right click and save. Then you go back to Silhouette. You go to File. You go to Merge. And then you look up wherever you save your images. Then click on OK. You have the zoom in and out button right here, which is the plus and the minus sign. I'm going to zoom out and I'm just going to make this smaller. Because I do have version 4.4 of Silhouette, it automatically traces my PNG. So if you look closely on this image, it has a red outline around it because it was traced. So while my image is selected, I'm going to go to the line style panel. I'm going to click on the color. I'm going to click on the no color option. Okay. Then I also have some stars that I saved. Then I'm going to change the outline color to no color. And then I'm going to right click and duplicate to add more stars. Then when I like how everything looks, I'm going to click here on my screen, drag my mouse over everything, right click and group this together. Then I'm going to put this right up here. And then while it's selected, I'm going to go to the replicate panel on my right, and where it says fill to page, I'm going to click there so I can fill it to the page, and I'm going to print. I'll be cutting this out by hand. How do you print? You're going to go to the printer icon up here. You're going to click on print. You're going to select the printer that you're going to be using. I am using an EcoTank 16600. I'm going to click on preferences. I'm going to be printing from the back of my printer. So where it says paper source, I'm going to put paper tray. Then I'll make sure that my orientation is on portrait. Paper type, I like to always leave it on premium presentation paper mat. No matter what paper I'm printing, I always leave it on premium presentation paper mat. Then how many prints you're going to be printing, then you click on OK, and then you print, all right? Now, if by any means a customer contacted you that they wanted you to decorate their labels for them, how do you send this to your customer? You need to save this as a PDF file. If you have business edition, you are able to save as an SVG, PDF, JPEG, and PNG and Silhouette file. So you will go to File. You will go to Save As, Save to Hard Drive. Where it says Save As Type, go down where it says Portable Document Format. That means PDF. You save this, you name it, and you put it in the, make sure that you're saving it to the folder that you want. And then you go to your email and email your customer the PDF file. Also, if you don't have a printer at home, you also save it as a PDF file. You can save it to your USB stick or email the company where you're printing at and print it over there, all right? So I'm going to print everything out. I'm going to cut everything out, and then we're going to put it on the bags.
Alright guys, here is the final result. I hope you enjoyed this quick little tutorial on how you could customize your own popcorn bags. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up and comment down below any other videos you would like to see from me. If you're not subscribed yet, please feel free to subscribe and click on the notification bell to be notified every time I upload a new video. If you would like to purchase anything from me, feel free to message me on Facebook or Instagram at Ingenious Creations LLC. If you don't have no social media, feel free to email me at ingenioucreations@yahoo.com. If you do try out these popcorn bags, feel free to post a picture in my crafting group, Ingenious Creations Crafting Lounge. I would like to see everything that you create, and I hope everyone's having a blessed day. Bye-bye.